Can you imagine living within just a stone's throw away from all these wildlife teeming in Monkey Hill? I surely would love the opportunity, but it's just too expensive. One of those apartments will set you back between $2 to $3 million. But all this wildlife is teeming here for a reason. It's because many locals are feeding them here. There are also people who come here daily to feed the not-so-wild animals too. Stray dogs. You will often see piles of dog chow at regular interval along the road. It's a 2 kilometers long road, and these feeders come here almost daily to feed them. These dog feeders are just as dedicated as those monkey feeders. When I first visited Monkey Hill in 2008, I actually frowned upon these feeders. But not so much now, as we humans waste over 3,500 tons of food in Hong Kong alone every day. I am not sure who has committed more of an offense in nature's eye. Besides, without these kind-hearted feeders keeping an eye out for her, she wouldn't still be around with us. And I am grateful for their interventions. The least I could do is not to criticize them, and help to clean up the trash they leave behind sometimes. What a chubby little girl she is now. And she is playful too. I wonder where the other monkeys are, not least her best friend, Boopa. It looks as though it's strictly a family outing today. Now that must be one of Teenie's aunt. It's cumbersome to carry a big lens around, but the clarity it affords is really unparalleled. Besides, it got them curious and attracts them too. And Tiny can't hold his curiosity any longer. And now Teenie too. I wonder how long these brother and sister will figure out that it's their very own reflections that they're seeing in my lens, not another random monkey. I think Teeny has figured it out and has lost interest in it already. But not his brother Tiny. Isn't Teeny smart? Yes, Teeny is definitely the smarter of the two. And Teeny's long gone. But as smart as she is, she can't say no to a sprinkle of peanuts from a car passing by. And I think Teeny can keep her goodies nowadays. She is probably too big for her mum Tina to pin her down. so they've been waiting out here for their one last snack before going back into the forest. And it's not a bad catch at all. No one steals from her anymore. And this is good news. With all the extra food going around, our little girl will grow. No longer the little helpless thing she once was. Another car passing by, more goodies. Don't you think our little girl is becoming a bit too chubby of late? But she will remain a wild animal at heart, and she will never lose her instinct to forage.